Welcome out to another episode of It's All Been Done Radio Hour. This week we have a Packer and Ratcliff episode called The Life, the Universe, and Everything, which is episode 42. Definitely a purposeful reference. Before we begin, we want to thank Circle 270 Media, which this podcast is a part of, and we want to thank It's All Been Done Presents, our parent network, found at IABDPresents.com. Please check it out. We also want to mention, if you like watching video versions of podcast episodes, It's All Been Trekked is now releasing the video versions to Patreon donors. You can support us at patreon.com/IABD. At the $2 level, you'll get all the regular episodes starting pretty recently. Before that, we were only releasing the audio, but now you can get the video of the hosts talking, and that is unedited, unlike the audio, so you get the extra little stories and tangents that we cut out. At the $5 level, you'll also get the special episodes. Now enjoy this episode of Packer and Ratcliff.
Our next feature today is Packer and Ratcliff, everyone's favorite immortal, time-traveling, dimension-shifting duo.
Hello! I'm James Packer.
And I'm Nicholas Ratcliff.
And I'm Tim the Time Machine. My name stands for Technology for Innovative Movement. We are two refined gentlemen whose acquaintance you must make.
As you witness our adventures, your breath we will take.
We never tarry in a single locale very long.
But if you tire of us, we are sure to move along.
Are you done?
Almost. Long. Okay, now I'm done.
You've been practicing.
I have.
When they founded Packrat Comics back so very long ago, they did not realize just how many places we would go.
From Amsterdam
to Timbuktu, from Portland
to Paris,
from 4954 to 1383.
We travel in a time machine bought from Mr. Wells.
That's me.
Tim, do not make us yell.
I flit through outer space from one dimension to another.
We've skimmed the tops of pyramids.
And wrestled Whistler's mother.
We traveled through both time and space.
And space and time, you'll see.
That's basically what I just said.
I beg to differ, P. Through thick and thin, we stick so close, like honey to a knife.
We persevere, we see it through. He's kinda like my wife.
He is.
I'm Packer.
Tim
and Ratcliff.
Our bond is that of brothers. At least it surely would be if we weren't each other's lovers.
Tim, you are not our lover.
Oh, better point.
We're the cream of the cross. Society's best.
No, we did it.
We're certainly much better than this radio show suggests. We're tip of the iceberg, top of the tree.
Two fabulous fellas.
And then there is me.
We're funky, spunky monkeys, as cheeky as can be.
I always want to shimmy to
this. I know, right?
Okay.
We're Packer and Ratcliff.
And Tim!
Wish I had a boa.
Yes, Packer and Ratcliff.
And Tim! Ooh,
do we have Tim. A costume budget for this?
Packer and Ratcliff.
And Tim. Oh, I'm sorry. It sounds like fun and a boa constrictor.
Tonight's episode, the 42nd of the series, is entitled Life, the Universe, and Everything. We begin on Tim as Packer and Ratcliff witness the Big Bang.
Spectacular! Don't you agree, dear Ratcliff?
Well, if you say so, Pete, it's difficult to tell from way out here. My opera glasses were not designed for such a distance.
Well, we couldn't exactly have had Tim get us any closer, could we? Lest we'd be ripped apart by the explosion.
Well, I guess not. Still rather anticlimactic, if you ask me.
The creation of the entire universe, something no other living creature has been able to witness. Anticlimactic?
Yes, but look at all of what the creation has resulted in.
It resulted in us.
Well, I hadn't thought of that. Perhaps I was a bit harsh.
Oh, sirs, if I may interrupt.
Shut up, Tim. Did we not tell you to give us quiet time?
Yes, you'd think 2,000 square feet would allow us a little space from time to time. It is measly compared to our estate back home, but still, it's
But
still
sirs, I am all 2,000 square feet.
Excuses are easy, Tim. Do you want to be easy?
I don't know how to answer that, sir.
Then you best not. Now, if we could get back to...
Sirs, I think I found something positive that we could do to change the timeline for the better, like you asked.
I believe I asked that if you thought of such a thing, to not share it with us.
You did indeed, dear Ratcliff. He isn't very obedient, machine, is he?
But, sirs, I think you'll want to hear me out.
I doubt it.
It's about Master Larry.
Larry? The man who helped bring us back together?
Oh, the very same.
Larry is gone, Tim. He's out of our life, back to his own time and dimension. I do not wish to dwell on him any further.
But, sir...
No, Tim, I am grateful for his assistance in my hour of need, but that does not mean I wish to see him again.
Ratcliff, if Tim thinks that
I have made up my mind.
But, sir, if I may...
No, Tim, you may not. Take us somewhere fun. I'd like a night date.
Date.
A date night. I'd like a date that occurs at night. I'd like a night with a date in it that involves me and him and just you for the beginning, but not for the whole duration because, oh my God, you are always around. But we do need you to get to the night which occurs the date for the two of us and sometimes you, but not completely.
Date night.
Okay, so let me get this straight. You want a night date on a date of a night, but the date night is a night date night. Wait.
A date night.
So more, yes.
Date. It's so simple.
So, okay, I think I got it. You want it more fun than the Bing Bang, sir?
Well, that wouldn't be hard. I found that rather dull.
Very well, sirs. Bobbity boop, 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 bobbity boop.
A short time later, in a small bistro in a dimly lit alley.
Oh, that was a superb meal.
It was. You know, I had my doubts given the dark locale, but it was rather satisfying.
Watch it, Ratcliff. You might give it too glowing of a review.
Oh, never.
Is there something to matter, beloved?
What do you mean?
You seem a bit distracted this evening.
No, not at all. I'm with the man I love in a restaurant that I actually enjoy. How could it possibly get any better?
You're not homesick, are you?
Oh, goodness, no. I mean, yes, I miss the servants waiting on us hand and foot, but I don't miss the company of so many other individuals.
Hey, how was everything?
Oh, quite good.
Even better before you interrupted us, Larry.
Oh, my apologies. My name's Doug.
That's what I said.
Okay, I just wanted to check on you, so I'd be happy to give you a bit more time.
The more the better.
You can bring the check now. Thank you very much.
My pleasure. I'll be back in a jiff.
Oh, it's pronounced gif. Okay, he's gone.
Ratcliff, my love, you can deny it all you want, but something besides me is on your mind.
Well, then let's get back to Tim and change that.
You get a perverse bit of pleasure doing things in front of him than scolding him for witnessing it, don't you?
I admit nothing, but yes, yes, I do. It is so funny how he can't actually leave us alone, but we tell him he must. It messes with his little brain.
I admit taunting Tim is a delightful pastime, but are you sure you don't want to talk first?
Oh, talk. I like our sappy time, but hasn't this whole dinner been enough foreplay?
Of course. I'll pay, and we'll go.
Later, back in Tim.
Phew, Ratcliff. You have outdone yourself.
I have, haven't I? You better not have been watching, Tim.
Oh, sirs, I try not to, but you are inside of me.
Don't be crass, Tim.
We do try to forget about that when we're inside of each other.
I'm sorry, sirs, but I did deactivate the syntap.
What are you saying? That we smell bad?
No, sir. I just, you see...
No, it's all right, Tim. You can leave that off. We won't need it anymore anyway.
As you wish, sir.
Packer, I think that you...
No, you're Packer. I'm Ratcliff. I've been meaning to set up a drinking lounge in that spare room we have. I'm going to go do that. You figure out who we are.
But it's so late, and I am obviously drunk, and I don't even know where we are right now.
I know. I'm Ratcliff, and I'll come to bed soon. I'm just not that sleepy, Packer.
All right, dear Ratcliff. See, I got it right that time. I wish I knew what I could do to cheer him up.
What's troubling Master Ratcliff so?
I suspect you know as well as I do, Tim.
Righto. But if he had let me...
No, Tim. That's not his way. If there was just only some other way that we could...
Sir?
Tim? Tim, call that woman that runs Pimmer Labs.
Camelie Dinson, sir.
Is she the one that is in charge of it now? I mean, in 2019.
Oh, yes, sir.
Get her on the line. I have an idea, and I'd like to speak with her.
Oh, goody, right away, Master Packer.
What has Ratcliff so down? What is Packer's idea? I promise we'll get to both next month. Sort of. But not in another episode of Packer and Ratcliff.
It's All Been Done Radio Hour number 265, Packer and Ratcliff number 42, Life, the Universe, and Everything, was written by Jerome Wetzel and directed by Nick Arganbright. It starred Chase McCants as James Packer, Dallas Ray as Nicholas Ratcliff, Nick Arganbright as Tim the Time Machine, and Shane Stefanchik as Doug. It was narrated by Ryan Yohe. Our podcast editor is Chris Allen. Our Foley artist is Seamus Talty. Our technical director is Shane Stefanchik. Our music director is Kristin Green. Theme songs composed by Nathan Haley. Our script editor is Keith Jackson. Please check out our website, itsallbeendoneradiohour.com, where you can get to our shop and buy script books of Universe Journey, The Top-Notch Tangler, Daniel Kravitz, and more coming soon, as well as the Universe Journey novel, t-shirts, including the Meow Meow I Am Not Evil t-shirt, and more. Have a great week.
You seem a bit distracted this evening.
Well, I've got rehearsal. So. Not at all. I'm with the man I love in a restaurant that I actually enjoy. How could it possibly get any better?
My pleasure. I'll be back in a jiff.
I believe it's pronounced jiff, and he's gone.
It's All Been Done presents
Who's Got the Time?